Football's a funny game, isn't it? One match and the world falls apart. A loss to Arsenal, a London derby. Yes, a really poor performance. And you probably watched my match review and reaction to that game. And I was very angry and disappointed. So funny because a win puts Chelsea second. You know, the mood is lifted around Chelsea. A 3-0 win in a London derby at West Ham. Then potentially another win. And then, what, are we title challengers again? The mood constantly is fluctuating. But no, Chelsea put in a really poor performance against an Arsenal side that had been in poor form. But of course, turned up for this game and put in an excellent performance. And of course, quite rightly, Chelsea fans have reacted to a very poor performance in the London derby against Arsenal. A lot of people have gone to Lampard out on Twitter. I've actually uninstalled Twitter on my phone to have a bit of a sort of detox from all of the toxicity on that platform. This is a match review of Chelsea's next game, but I really want to take this opportunity to express how I understand frustrations. Chelsea Football Club is a massive club and we've got huge ambitions and an excellent squad of very talented players. So when they don't turn up, when the coach makes incorrect tactical decisions, everyone has the right to be upset. But the fact is, I didn't feel comfortable with a lot of this Frank Lampard slander. Like, he had he did an excellent job last season, all things considered. Such a good job. He got nominated for Manager of the Year award in his debut season at Chelsea in a very difficult situation. He's into his second season, only just in exceptional circumstances. There's a global pandemic. He's a bunch of new players that are yet to bed in, and the schedule is incredibly difficult. So there's a lot of difficult circumstances surrounding this season. So I do feel a little bit disappointed when I see abuse towards the manager. And I myself criticise the coach's decision. It's not a given that Frank Lampard's going to be a success at Chelsea. Yes, as a massive Chelsea fan my whole life, of course, I adore the fact that Frank Lampard is Chelsea manager. For me, that's like a dream come true. And you pair that with him actually doing an excellent job in his first season, and you pair that with him doing some, you know, great work in the transfer window in terms of alluring players to join Chelsea and selling them a project, he's ticking a lot of boxes. But that doesn't mean he can't be criticised, and he has to be criticised. He's made some poor decisions, and, you know, a part of me is going, well, of course he's making poor decisions. He's a young coach, you know, developing and hopefully getting better. And then part of me is thinking, it's not good enough. I think one thing that I wanted to assert in this message before I preview the game against Aston Villa is Frank Lampard had obviously a long, illustrious playing career. You know, one of the world greats, Chelsea's perhaps greatest ever player, top goal scorer, all those accolades. I don't think Frank Lampard has this ego to be a really successful manager across loads of different clubs and countries, you know, like a Jose Mourinho or something like that. He hasn't got that in him. I think he likes the idea of being a manager, but the pinnacle for him is managing Chelsea Football Club. That's the desired target. Jose Mourinho, Antonio Conte, Maurizio Sarri, Carlo Ancelotti, for them, the pinnacle of their careers wasn't managing Chelsea Football Club. Yes, it's a big club and, you know, they did well or whatever, but they don't care about Chelsea Football Club ultimately. You know, that sounds harsh, and maybe it's someone like Carlo Ancelotti, but ultimately, it's just another football club. They've managed loads of big football clubs. Frank Lampard, this is the club he loves. Does that mean he should get special treatment? No. Does that mean I have a sort of bias feeling towards him? Yes, probably. The reason why I'm saying that is because he himself is such a Chelsea fan. He loves the club, and you've got 12 years of playing, of how he's reacted, how he's spoken about the club, how he celebrated goals, how he's basically just been integrated with Chelsea. He represents what Chelsea is. He was part of it being built again in 2003 and 4. You know, he is what Chelsea is right now. He will not want Chelsea to lose or stay in the job at the expense of Chelsea, is what I'm trying to say. If he thinks he can't do it, he's not gonna just stay for the money. He's not gonna do what Conte and Mourinho did and manipulate the club. He's just gonna like leave, because he's like, this is the club I love and I don't think I can take it forwards, or we're not moving forwards here. I just wanted to express myself on this. This is why I uninstalled Twitter, because there's a lot of people that are just abusing him. you know, and you have your right to say, I don't think this man is equipped to be Chelsea manager right now. And, you know, although I have my concerns, I've seen a lot of positives myself, but don't abuse this guy who's our greatest ever player and who would always put the club before his own managerial career, which is a completely and entirely unique situation for us Chelsea fans to be in and for Chelsea Football Club to be in. Will it work? Hopefully. I back the coach, but, you know, I understand if Chelsea finish outside the top four this season, it's probably not good enough and we'll get canned, probably. Anyway, I've said my piece. Be respectful to each other, and let's get into this match review. Right, so Chelsea have a very, very short turnaround before they play Aston Villa. Like, a day, basically. It's absolutely mental. There's no point whinging about it. This is what football is at the moment. So let's just talk about it. Aston Villa are an incredibly good team. They keep winning. Their form is great. Their recruitment has been excellent in the summer. And they're winning games. They look great. Grealish looks great. You know, they're combining well in the midfield and the final third. And they've got a strong belief and team work ethic. Even when they go down to 10 men, they see games out. This is the formation that they used last time out in the Premier League. Whether they'll use the same players or not, I'm not so sure. You can imagine both teams will have to rotate a bit. But Chelsea have probably afforded the opportunity to rotate a little bit more. Now, there needs to be a reaction from these Chelsea players. They all sort of, I think, realise that wasn't good enough. I think Frank Lampard needs to do a lot of self-investigation? I'm not sure that's a word. Basically, Lampard needs to look at himself and how he's deploying what players where and try to tighten things up. And basically, the effort on the pitch needs to be increased because that was a dismal performance against Arsenal. So I'm going to show you a lineup that I've pulled out of the air that I think might play against Aston Villa, but I just don't know. So let's switch pages and have a look at who I've picked. Edu Mendy will keep his place in goal, I believe. And I actually think Zuma will start, but I think there's a chance that Antonio Rudiger will come in. That's depending on what Thiago Silva's energy levels are like, being a 36-year-old. If he's good to go, I think the centre-back partnership remains the same, but there's a chance someone like Rudiger, who's apparently next in line, comes in. For me, Cesar Azpilicueta has to start at either right-back or left-back. I'm going to put him in right-back and drop Reece James because he looks like he's well off the pace and he's not sharp and he's not good to go. Azpilicueta should have started against Arsenal. He knows what that game's all about. He would have performed well. He should start in this game. But now, is this difficult, isn't it? I'm going to say Emerson Palmieri. Now, this is a big drop-off of quality from Ben Chilwell, but similarly, I don't think Ben Chilwell's ready and good to go, and Emerson has been okay of late. This is a massive game. We have to win it, but energy levels could ultimately be the difference, certainly in the fullback positions in this game, you know, for both teams in terms of rotation. So I'm going to put Emerson in there. God help us. Now, I'm going to keep N'Golo Kante at the CDM role. He played poorly, okay? He played poorly against Arsenal. He actually got better when he got pushed forward into an 8 against Arsenal. But I think N'Golo Kante, if he can rest up, I know he got taken off for rest as well, I think Frank's going to play him. And I think Kante's such a professional player, he will turn up in this game a lot better, I'm hoping. And similarly, Mason Mount, I am going to start him as well. He's played a lot of football, but he came out and he did that interview post-match in Arsenal. He says, look, I want to play, I'm good to go. He wants to prove himself. He knows what it is to play for Chelsea. And I think this is his opportunity to really show the fans why he is a future Chelsea legend in the making. So that's an opportunity there as well. Now, I don't know between Kovacic and Havertz. I think probably Kovacic again, so we're going to keep the same midfield, because again, Kovacic was brought off. I think that might be resting him a little bit. Havertz has looked okay a couple of times off the bench. I expect him to come off the bench again. Now this is where we really spice things up. Callum Hudson-Odoi has to start this game. I think Frank Lampard pretty much implied that he would when he spoke about him post-match after Arsenal. He looked like our best player when he came on against Arsenal, of course made the goal for Tammy. He'll start right wing. Now, Pulisic looks great as well. So he'll start left wing. We have two actual wingers here. And although Tammy has got 3 goals in 2 games, and he did play pretty well, I think Giroud is going to start this game. So I think Giroud up top, flanked by Pulisic and Hudson-Odoi, just because Giroud scores goals and he's rested. And then, you know, we always have Tammy to come off the bench, or Timo Werner to play down the middle off the bench. But yes, rest Timo Werner. And yes, don't play him on the wing. So that's how I feel about it. Let's get rid of the lineup and talk about this game a little bit more. So of course, this game is a must win. It just is, right? It is. If we lose to Villa after Arsenal, we'll be dropping down into sort of mediocrity in the table and it'll be a crisis. Does it mean Frank Lampard's going to get the sack? No. And should he get the sack after that? Probably not, considering everything of what's going on. But then we've got City next, and things could get very, very dismal for Chelsea, guys. I'm sorry to say it, but winter is coming, or winter is here. So yeah, let me know what you think. Be respectful in the comment section, you know, be kind to each other. No abuse, no name calling for players or the manager, but do express your opinion down in the comment section below. Drop a like on the video because it does help me out a lot, man. Subscribe to Football Therapy if you're new for daily content. That's it from me. Enjoy the football, and I will hopefully see you later. Way so tough with that bad boy tuck. I'ma get it how I'm living, I'ma walk the walk. Outline my lines, I rap through thought. Body bag the verse, outline the chalk. In my life seen trouble, hustle on the double. Silence on the trigger like my pick got a muzzle. Yo chick like to guzzle, bad boy stay in trouble. I only love this paper, sorry I don't. I love me baby.